गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम आशुतोष रंजन, साइंस टीचर ऑफ मॉडर्न इंग्लिश स्कूल बिहार शरीफ ब्रांच। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट योर सेवेंथ चैप्टर गेटिंग टू नो प्लांट्स। मीन्स इन दिस चैप्टर आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट प्लांट्स। स्टूडेंट्स, यू हैव ऑब्जर्व अराउंड योर होम, स्कूल एंड इन योर सराउंडिंग्स, देयर आर सो मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ प्लांट्स आर फाउंड इन योर सराउंडिंग्स। These plants are of different types. Some plants are very small, but very small in size. Some plants are some larger than, bigger than these small plants. Some are very large. So when you look in your surroundings in different directions, you will find that in your surroundings plants are found, different types of plants are found, and these different types of plants are in different shape and size. Some are very small, some are in middle size, medium sized, and some are in very large size. You will also observe that life cycle of some plants is very short. Lifetime of some plants is some more, and lifetime of some other plants are very long. So these are some facts, these are some points on the basis of we classify different types of plants into different groups. For help in a study, we classify these all types of plants in different groups. So in this chapter, we will discuss different types of plants, different categories of plants, which are classified on the basis of their structure, their size. As I have told previously, that some are very small, some are some larger, some are very large. You have also seen some plants are also very big. They cannot stand erect. Either they need support to stand erect, or they spread on ground. So these are some different properties which are found in different types of plants. So on the basis of these different properties, plants are categorized, plants are differentiated in different groups. Some main groups are herbs, shrubs, trees, whereas some other groups are also climbers and creepers. So overall we can see that these are five groups. In these five groups, all plants which are found in our surroundings are categorized in these groups, in these five groups, on the basis of their structure, on the basis of their strength, on the basis of their size. So this is the basic introduction of your seventh chapter. In my next lecture, I will discuss one by one these categories briefly, and also I will discuss properties of these different groups of plants. So for today, that's all. Thank you. Have a nice day.